18 million voters will vote for the first time in this election. These voters will play a major role in the polls. If you are a young voter watching this, your vote matters. But how do these young people select their candidates? What are the issues they are concerned about? Let's find out.
While you're voting, how did you choose your candidate?
Whether every family in Kerala will have a party background, it's time for us to change that party thought process and choose the right person, whether it's from any party it is.
Empathy. I think our leaders should have empathy for our issues, and people who represent us at the highest level should have empathy for us.
I'll be looking forward to the leaders who care more about north side of Karnataka, not just Bangalore. We are hearing about water crisis a lot nowadays because it's happening in Bangalore. But water crisis issue is happening in north side of Karnataka since many years. And politicians are not caring about it even after many people who stay there in north Karnataka go and report it.
There should be more student representation in politics, and some of the student welfare schemes, if they could help the underprivileged students and they could benefit from the educational system of India.
In India, we know that most of the politicians are not literate or not quite aware of the basic policies that's there.
I would check on the background history a little bit of the party. I think candidate, I actually would check history on candidate, because if the candidate is good, there's a good name for the party. So I think I would go on based on the history of that candidate particular work.
So did you feel any national issues or other regional issues which determined your vote or which affected you or which you are concerned about?
It is really political. The government is not at all caring about the people's concerns. The unemployment, everything is happening here, but they are not even caring about this, and they are just running behind what they are beneficial of.
Like recently we heard the electoral bond scheme, which is rather a very big issue, because the gravity of the situation is such that the companies funding these parties, for instance, there's a company called Vedanta. It is under scrutiny for bending Indian energy laws. And a company like that funding our leaders, our political parties that we are choosing is problematic. For rest of India, CAA is a different scenario. But for Assam, people there are looking for identity. Since the 1980s, the Assam Accords, Assamese people there have been looking to solidify their identity.
Then unemployment rates, I would say, in a national level, taking the past traces, more than 10 years, it's been on a hike. Like, unemployment rate is very high in the country. We have seen many issues coming from the places such as northeastern states and also southern part of India, which is not much addressed also, like the Sonam Wangchuk, the Ladakh issue. He's being stopped. Even the mainstream media is not covering it much.
Scams, the corruptions that are going on, because all of us, we recently came across this electoral scam and various coal scams. So I think in the past 5 years of duration, the country has witnessed a lot of corruption, a lot of money loss, especially of civilians.
It's not from just one party like BJP or Congress. Everyone is involving BJP, Congress, all the politics and religion things, which I don't really like. So I think if people would like to work on that, like keep religion separate and politics separate, I think that would be better.
This election season, your right to choose puts you at the heart of it again.
We'd like to be your eyes and ears.
Choose the journalism and media that serves democracy and you.
Simply log on to newslaundry.com/2024 election fund and choose an amount of your choice for the reports of your choice.